Hello friends, as we all know, the exams are right by the corner, so we just thought of doing this topic because many students come across this problem that how to write any of the answer perfectly. So I am your Harshadat going to tell you 5 tips on how to write a perfect answer in our science examination. Now this examination can be of any subject like biology, physics. So let's begin with the point one. Now the point one is very easy and very basic, which we are studying from like standard first. So that point is handwriting. Yeah, even now when if at all you are in graduation or post graduation or your PhD degree, you do require to have proper handwriting. If at all you have proper handwriting, the examiner finds it very easy to read your answer, and hence he can recollect that the student is very sharp and he is able to understand the concept, hence he can write the answer properly. So always keep in mind, keep your handwriting as neat as possible, never change pens or the ink in between. Now this was the basic tip which we all should follow, even we used to follow when we were kids. So the second point is basically clear the concepts in form of points. Many of the times from childhood we used to write the exams or our answers in paragraphs, like your first paragraph should be the introduction, second paragraph should be like how to do this and the other stuffs. But now from now onwards, always keep in mind, if at all the examiner finds it very easy to read, he will find very easy to give you marks. So always write your answer in points like 1, 2, 3 or ABC, whatever you are convenient with. Go on with this point system because it is very easy to write points. Always underline any of the important words if you have in your answer. Okay. That is the second point. Now the third point is always support your answer with the diagram. Now in physics or in biology also, we come across many of the diagrams which are given in our textbook or our reference books, but we usually neglect them because students say that, oh, my drawing is not nice and all the stuff. But we have to remember that if at all you are unable to write your answer properly, but your diagram is 100% or 100% correct, then there is chances that the examiner will give you half of the marks at least. So that is one added bonus to you. So always try to support your answer with proper diagram. Now, the fourth point is we have to prepare a proper body for answer. Now, what is the meaning of preparing proper body of the answer? Like for example, I have to write an answer on short note on human heart. So I have written a note. I have prepared some notes like this. So while writing, first point is definition of human heart. So what is the definition of human heart? That you have to write in first point. Now second point will be parts of human heart. A third point will be working of human heart, like how human heart works, all the parts, what they do. Some carry deoxygenated blood, some carry oxygenated blood, there is aorta, some veins, arteries, everything. You have to write everything and how it works in this point, that is third point. Now if at all the third point or the working part is quite longer, you can subdivide it into other points. Like for example, working, third point will be working of human heart. Under that you can write A. So the left ventricle contains this blood. B, right ventricle contains this blood. So this is how you have to write points or give points to the answer. Now the fourth point is function of human heart. How the human heart functions, that we have to write in this point. Then fifth is basically problems related to heart, or what will happen if heart is not working properly, that also we have to write. This is going to be fifth point. And then sixth point would be diagram. Now whenever you draw any diagram, keep in mind and be sure about labeling and write the spellings of the labeling very correctly. You should not make any mistakes while writing any of these spellings. So keep that in mind. Now this is all for like 10th standard or 12th standard people. Now if at all you all are the my subscribers, they are from like graduation or they have completed a graduation and they are pursuing post graduation, and if at all they have to remember how to write this, then for example, I'll tell you, write a life cycle on T4 bacteriophage. Now what all you'll write? And the first point was definition was or definition of heart. Now here you will be writing what is bacteriophage, correct? Now the second part here was parts of human heart. So here you will be writing parts of T4 bacteriophage. That is second point. Then third is working of human heart. Now you don't have any working of T4 bacteriophage, but you do have life cycle. Yes, the main answer comes over here. That is T4 bacteriophage. The life cycle of the T4 bacteriophage, that you have to write in points, and then you have to add sub points if the answer is too lengthy. Then function of human heart. Now if at all T4 bacteriophage has no such specific function, now here you can write what are the hosts which are involved in T4 bacteriophage. Now fifth point is problems related to heart. So fifth point, you can give what are the problems which T4 bacteriophage can cause to, correct, the host. Then sixth point will be same, that is diagram, the diagram of whole life cycle of T4 bacteriophage. Okay, one more reminder, I'll be linking the T4 bacteriophage videos in the description box, so don't forget to check that T4 bacteriophage video. That will be very helpful for you. So that was all about 6 points. Now the 5th point from my tips is that whenever you do practicals, this is mainly for graduate people and postgraduate people, whenever you do any of the practical, you write some approach or you write how to solve any of the problem. So you do some experiments, like for example, you all might have done the plaque assay. So whenever you did the plaque assay, that plaque assay you can write over here. In short, that how can you obtain the plaques in a petri plate using the host, that is E. coli. So this is how we can write a short note or life cycle of T4 bacteriophage. So that was all about tips for writing answer in exam. Now if you have any questions, or if you want any tips regarding how to study during exam, don't forget to comment in the comment box. Also, if you are still watching the video and you have completed all your exams, don't worry. We also have some videos linked in the description box below. You just have to click the inverted triangle which is there besides the title bar, wherein we are explaining what to do after BSc Biology, BSc Microbiology, BSc Life Sciences, and what to do after MSc, the main MSc part, and what are the job options available after MSc. So this was all about the tips. Thank you for watching Noah Bio. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and like and share with all your friends so that they can write their answer paper hassle-free. Thank you.